Hello, people of the tubes.
Hello, welcome to Gear Squid.
It's Crusader, and I'm watching a video of me playing the game, and this time I'm gonna make it so unique. Look at this, I'm actually watching it and recording me watching it.
Whoa, that's some meta shit right there.
And this allows you to skip forward and stuff. Oh yeah, I can increase speed, can't I? I wonder if this is gonna make the sound really weird.
Yeah, it is.
Is it? Look at that, building all the shit. I had that.
Beautiful.
I have this at the lowest speed, so that I could build enough. Cause, not sure if you saw, but I'm playing against, I think 6 different enemies. Or 7.
Once again, you are in another corner.
Yeah, look at me. I'm so cornered by all the mighty AI. Oh man, look how cool that is when I build that fast.
I guess we did put this baby in a corner.
Oh no, not the baby.
Well, where did all the tree goes?
Fucking camels in the way. Oh, that's just when you flatten it. There's two.
Every time he gets me.
Yeah, sure does.
Kind of looks like Age of Empires.
Kind of, but it's actually very unique in many ways. Okay, that's enough fast forwarding. Oh wait, I don't actually know how to make speed normal.
Oh no.
Yes, however do I make speed normal?
All the good things will just go straight past. Like that one food you really liked.
Oh no.
And you just didn't want to stop eating it.
Oh yeah. Don't you just hate when that happens and then you get sick of it? I can't tell if it's too slow.
You like eat one thing, you're like, good god, this tastes heavenly, I wish I had another.
Oh yeah.
And then you never get another.
I have one piece of food that I can never get old with, and it's bolognese crisps.
Wow.
Those are the best. Like, I can never get, like, sick of them or something. You know?
Peanut butter, I can never get sick of, apart from Reese's peanut butter cups and stuff like that. Which is very, very weird, because obviously I'm Reese, so...
Oh, just down there after you. Know.
Yeah.
Alright, so...
Then what?
By the way, I found out that the best melee unit in the game is monks. Look at those fat monks over there with their sticks. You don't think so, but they're the best. They only cost 10 gold, and they can defeat a mace man in 1v1.
Nice.
Florian fat shaming monks since 2016.
That's right. The only drawback is that they're extremely slow, but for defense that makes them perfect. I mean, that being the only drawback makes them perfect. Because you just put them on the tower, and then when the enemy scales the tower, they just get pummeled by 10 monks and their sticks.
Have you ever tried to work on a game like this, Florian?
I have, but then the development team fell apart.
Oh, really?
Oh yeah, but I was way early. I probably couldn't have handled it anyways. It was awful. Anyways, you see, I'm building there.
I can imagine.
Did I mention this video is 3 hours long? That's why I'm going to be skipping forward. Right, let's see what happens. Yeah, I built more stuff on the tower. I got some slingers that are also really cheap and they have really short range, but they're good for... They're good when you do get in their short range, so...
I guess you could be bookmarking where we stop then.
We're not going to stop. I'm just going to skip forward.
What, we're doing the whole 3 hours?
No, I'm going to be skipping forward.
Yeah, it's not going to take 3 hours.
Yeah, see, I already skipped 5 minutes.
Might
like,
as well be.
Half of it is building, so you know people don't need to see that.
Check this out. This is one tower, and there's an exploit where you can pull a lot of units in that one tower, and that way they're pretty hard to kill.
Nice.
Cool. Yeah, that's a pretty good exploit.
I should play this game.
I'm not sure if I should be doing it like that. It's a bit cheap, but there's not enough space to build towers there, and this is literally the only iron mine, and you need iron mines if you wanna... Well, I mean, this there's pretty much nothing that can give you gold in this map except for iron and stone.
So is this map random generated or?
No, this is a pre-made. This is a mission that was pre-made.
All right. So yep, purposely,
it's a campaign level.
So indeed. It purposely stopped you from getting too much room at the start.
Yeah, this is really just giving you the shaft right off this map.
Yeah.
And this mission. What happened with the slaves over there? Did they set my shit on fire? Oh, are they doing that now?
They're revolting again.
No, bad slaves.
Silly slaves.
That's not how. Wow, they were too dumb to set anything on fire. That's hilarious.
Know your place, damn it.
I had to restart this mission so many times to fix shit. Well, actually, the slaves hired by the enemies to set my shit on fire, so. They know their place. Actually, they're very obedient. They're willing to risk their life to oblige their lord.
What? You want me to walk in middle of an army? If you say so.
Oh, yeah. Just right under my tower, filled to the brim with archers and shields and monks.
No second thoughts.
Yeah. Look at all this shit, though. I mean, I am 15 minutes in and there's... I mean, this is the slowest speed, so that's only like 2 or 3 minutes in the actual game, but yeah. It's literally everything. Opposed to the other finale we did, this one is way harder because it doesn't have rats or pigs or any easy AI in it. This is just caliphs and wazirs and the wolf. And
guys who want to rip you a new one.
The lion heart, yeah, it's the worst. So I made some crossbowmen also, because that's the only way to kill armored units, I guess. The only good way.
Just shoot them in the weak spots.
Just penetrate them with those tiny little thingies. What are they called? Bolts, yeah, bolts.
Yeah, crossbows use bolts.
There, and look, this is... The Nisar, for example, one of the new Arabian leaders, he just spams lots of assassins that become invisible. And here they come out of nowhere and just lots of assassins. And that's really ass. And I have no gold and there's just no way to make gold except for that iron mine right there. But now they've wrecked it with the assassins.
And now what are you going to do now?
They're even destroying whatever I had on that tower, so I'm just really fucked. What do I do now? Is this one of the ones where I restart? I don't think so. I mean, I already lost shitload, so it would make sense to restart.
Cue it to your future past self.
Whatever do I do?
Damn it, Florian, what the hell are you doing? You retard.
No! Oh yeah, I'm gonna sell my bread. I can't even make bread because there's only one piece of green grass in this whole map that I have access to. And I put cows on it because I need the cows to make leather. By murdering them. So that's all I can do. So I need to buy grain in the market, which is going to be really expensive. But it's the cheapest way to buy food for your castle.
I'm going to sell it for gold. No!
Yeah. Actually, that is the main strategy I use in this game. Buying grain and then selling the food, the bread.
Nice. Smart man.
Yes, surprisingly that works because... Because one grain makes 8 bread, so
it really... That's quite a grain.
Yeah. It's not even genetically modified. There, look, my assassins are now... I mean, the enemy assassins are now dealing with these slingshots.
Game logic.
Oh, yeah.
You're just gonna expect to use one thing and pull out another thing out your ass?
Super grain. Oh yeah, I could have used the music to hear if it seems to be the proper speed. All right.
Maybe it's the most thickest piece of grain ever.
Oh yeah, it's so good, man. I don't even have. I don't even have the 10 gold required to hire more monks. It's ridiculous.
Oh. Florin, do you know how this is an isometric game?
Yes.
What would you class isometric as, 2D or 3D? A lot of people have different opinions.
Isn't isometric basically a 3D world but 2D over stuff? No. Or is it the opposite way around, actually?
People really don't know this, huh? Isometric is the opposite of perspective. If you don't know. I sold my bread then, by the way, which means I have no bread now because he's gonna wreck my granary with his assassin, so I had to do it. Oh, anyways, so basically it just means it's a 3D game that doesn't have perspective. As you see,
yeah,
the tower here is no bigger than the tower, this tower. In fact, it's smaller because it's a small tower, but yeah, that's no perspective going on, which means that this tile is as big as this tile.
Yeah, but it doesn't. But it uses 2D assets.
This does use 2D assets. You're right, but you can set Unity to be isometric, and then it will be 3D. But I suppose. Yeah. I guess they are 2D assets. I was contemplating if they were pre-rendered, but really they're just.
It's like Isaac.
It's the question. Just drawn. It's the question that everyone likes to discuss. They never know whether it's 3D or 2D because it's the opposite of perspective. But the thing about it is it can use 3D assets, but it can use 2D also. So technically, it could be both.
Is Isaac something like that?
Isaac, look at Isaac from above.
The rooms look 3D.
Indeed, but they don't get any large. Wow, look at that! He's got catapults, and they shot my fucking water thingy. Amazing.
I love how you're amazed by something you already played.
But maybe when you go back,
it's amazingly annoying how he actually shoots past my towers and shoots my firewatch. Oh, I reloaded. That's why I did. I didn't restart. Wow, that was a. I lost a lot of progress though, didn't I?
No.
Look at that, but let's just skip forward and see how I do it that time. I probably mismanaged somewhat, and now I'm managing it slightly better. Yeah, making monks, making everything. Now that I know the patterns of the enemy attacks, I guess it really helps. I guess it's a bit cheap, but what can you do? This is just outrageously hard, this mission.
Looks like it.
And look how fast these horse archers die, because he's too dumb to use them properly. The way you should be using them is running around, and then they shoot. The fool. Oh god, is that a trebuchet? Oh. Oh, he killed that little woodcutter hut there. That's why he was frolicking, because he... He used a massive trebuchet to bring down a little woodcutter hut.
I would do that.
I bet you would. Man, I used to build trebuchets in real life.
Wow, really?
Or catapults. Yeah, when I was young, I made tiny little catapults. It was awesome. I mean, not tiny.
They actually do damage.
They did lots of damage, yeah. I think they could throw a rock about 20 meters, yeah.
Cool, we tried to snipe people away from next door.
Oh, I think rednecks do that. Right, rednecks do that. Like they make trebuchets and shit. It's a TV show, I think.
Oh, I might want to watch that. I fucking love trebuchets. I'd really like to see something like that. They're actually pretty good. I think I might use some in this game too, but maybe not. Alright, let's skip forward some more. There's more slaves actually. Let's see how... Oh no, actually they're in no danger of going through because I have murder holes there. And also I'm sending out my monks, it seems, to fight the slaves.
Fight my slaves!
Oh yeah, and they're getting wrecked by the woodcutter, the slaves as well.
Yeah, you think you'd be scared of someone who uses an axe to chop down trees.
Well, all they have what is a torch.
What do slaves have?
A torch. They're weak.
Fire is super effective to steal. Don't you know your type matchups?
Yeah, you should try using a torch against someone who has an axe. Alright, I saved, so apparently I was happy with my progress. Good stuff, let's see.
Well, are you happy with it now anyway?
Oh, well, not so much. Look, there's the assassins again. Let's see if I handle them this time. More monks! Bring the monks to the assassins. Oh my god, look at all this streaming. Look at the stream of assassins coming
Damn.
In.
We're not being too assassiny about it. We're just going straight in.
Assassin stream.
Oh god.
That pun.
I wonder if I should use fire throwers on there. Or if they would set on fire my iron mines. Alright, more soldiers. Oh look, the assassins are too dumb to even do anything now, they're just standing there. Sometimes the AI is kind of stupid in this game.
Well, it is an old game.
Very old.
AI in lots of games is stupid.
So yeah.
Old or new.
Have you seen the new Skyrim, mate? The AI is still as stupid as it was in 2011.
Well yeah, but they're not supposed to build castles in that, at least.
True.
You don't know how bad this AI can get at building castles. Sometimes they just leave it open and you can just walk right in.
Yeah.
Well, not this time.
It's like they want them to die.
These castles are so fucking well fortified. You'll see how much I'm going to struggle with them.
I bet we will.
I bet we will. Okay, here. Now that he's just sending in. Oh, I guess that's the Emir. He's just the most financially successful of the Arabian lords, and all he does is just send so many units, so many well-armored, well-equipped units in, just lots of Arabian swordsmen coming down there.
Oh dear.
But they're gonna get wrecked by my crossbows, more or less. Less in this case, but there's some monks there that will kill them. Monks are also better than Arabian swordsmen, by the way. And Arabian swordsman cost 80 gold, opposed to the 10 gold that swordsman cost. The only advantage of the Arabian swordsman is that they are they're a lot better against arrows. Oh well. I wonder if melee units can penetrate armor.
Dabbing attacks?
I guess it depends what attack they have, but you'd think that the spears would be the best for dealing with armor.
Yeah, because they work stuff.
Indeed. They really penetrate.
I've got a question about Poor Mouse, actually.
Oh.
What? Okay. Like, what inspired the gameplay?
Oh, a bunch of stuff, actually. Yeah. I think most of all, Gex.
Because
of the tail
swipes. Yeah. and the bug's life because of the mushrooms and the seeds that you collect.
Yeah.
I skipped forward then, but I defeated the Arabian swordsman easy enough, and I'm constantly being attacked still. Now I'm building another tower, yeah.
I thought Dark Souls would be a good one.
Yeah, originally, but when I went into the actual design and mechanics, I guess these old games are really a lot like it too.
You got lives instead of checkpoints and all that.
The exploring reminds me of like Super Mario 64.
Oh yeah, that.
just the way you can like sort of traverse around the place.
Yep.
Yeah.
You can go into
pictures in that one, so it's a bit different. Yeah, that's the one. By the way, on top of those big towers, I gotta put ballistas, which is good against catapults, but the small tower has no ballista, so I get attacked with catapults on that small tower. I keep making these wooden shields to emit the arrows that get shot at my units.
What do you think of me if I played Super Mario 64 DS?
Oh, I'd love that. Please do.
Oh,
yeah,
dear.
Yeah.
I really want to.
I remember playing it when I was quite a bit younger, and I've always wanted to sit down and watch a gameplay of it, but I've I've only played
Super Mario 64, never the DS version.
I hardly had enough resources to repair that tower before he wrecked it, so I had to buy rocks. It was awful. I wonder
the
if
DS it, version's but... weird because you can play as multiple characters like Yoshi and stuff.
Yeah, you start playing as Yoshi instead of Mario.
Yeah, there's also
and
online
fact,
play with
Mario
it,
was
but it's minigames.
Yeah. The minigames are tied in with New Super Mario Bros.
Oh god.
Which I also played and 100%ed.
Look at these catapults, they're really wrecking me right now. Oh no! Look at that red health bar there. Terrible.
Oh.
No! Stop shooting it!
Nope.
Gotta specifically tell the ballistas to aim for the catapult, or else they might not do it. Oh my god! 14 HP left. Oh good, I killed the catapult. Alright, sorry, what were you talking about?
We were just talking about Super Mario 64 DS.
Oh yeah.
And how the
And that the minigames are the same as Super Mario Bros.
Minigames.
Which I 100% completed.
Yeah, there's
there's a minigame where like it's a minigame where you like Yoshi picks petals of a flower. Like She loves me not and such, and if you manage to get Will loves me, you win. It's completely random.
But who loves Yoshi?
Not Mario.
Yeah, no.
There was also actually a couple of new levels added to it as well, because you actually had to go through the levels to unlock Wario.
Yeah, and you get extra levels to
go Wario,
beat a boss to unlock the Yep.
Does he fart on people still?
I don't know, he seems Wario seems more like a melee fighter.
Right.
He has like...
Yeah.
He prefers to just go up to stuff and smash them. Unlike other characters where they are very agile, like Luigi is very agile.
Well, that's still melee.
I remember he's a bit slower, I think.
Oh, that's cool. God, yeah, just look how many swordsmen are coming in now. It's awful.
Also, we fixed like musks from Super Mario 64, like
the bugs?
Thing where, like this move you could do, like if you do like a backwards jump and then just do it very fast, you just go at 100 miles per hour on your ass, and you get to clip through things.
That's how I got past the infinite stairs.
Yeah,
I just done the backwards jump.
Yeah, I've got on the Wii U.
Same here. Yeah, like that's how I done it on the Wii U.
I also done it on my N64 when I had that, but mine's just getting fixed just now.
Oh, now there's Pikeman coming in as well.
I really get to hear Mario go, "Wah!" as he does it really fast. It's amazing.
Oh yeah, and sometimes he does like a major moonwalk at like 100 miles per hour as well.
Yeah.
Yeah, but you have to specifically do that, don't you? By doing it in the water or something.
You just gotta put the camera faced towards you. It's a really easy thing once you understand it, but it took a while for me.
It's basically long jumping backwards upstairs, and then you keep pressing the jump button, and then because
that's
you're
what I meant by
steps,
going
it
up really fast on your ass.
Yeah. Oh yeah, however will I survive this onslaught?
You won't, you will die.
No.
Rip.
I still have 3 hours here. Oh, I mean, 2 hours still. 3.5 hours is how long it really is. I just want to see how I defeat this... I guess I just shot it with the crossbow man. Or do I still have invisible ninjas there? No, actually, I do not. Alright.
What ninjas?
They're gone. They've been killed. For some reason, they wrecked the stairs to that tower, so they were too dumb to actually climb onto the tower. It was brilliant. Otherwise, they could have easily just cleared my tower and I would have been fucked. But now I built another tower there, and now they're gonna be not able to attack anymore.
Damn.
Oh, you're not pleased with me winning? Alright, let's skip forward more.
I was hoping for a defeat, man.
For AI.
Ultimate defeat.
Oh yeah, over 3 hours, sure.
So you never know.
At this point, I got the economy to be decent enough so that I could just make money over and over. And the defenses, they don't actually require a lot of attention. I just send some units every once in a while on there. So basically now I have to work on attacking them. But it's going to be really hard because they're so well fortified. And they constantly keep sending their units too. So it's really hard to break out to attack them. Because there's so many of them. Alright, let's see. Oh, they've killed the tower there also. Annoyingly. With catapults. Have you ever played any games like this, Reese?
When I was younger, I played. I can't even remember what it was. I think it was like Command and Conquer. In fact, no, it was Warcraft that I played actually.
That's a good game.
Yeah, but I really have very thin memories of it. Like, I can't remember too much. I'm pretty sure I played a different one as well.
Thin memories of it.
Yeah, like I don't know. My memory is not too good, so I remember certain things about it, but I can't remember like a lot.
Command and Conquer, you say?
Well, I think it may have been Command and Conquer that I played.
Right.
But I played Warcraft. I remember playing Warcraft because I was blown away by the graphics at the time. But
oh right.
Yeah. But that's what I mainly remember is the graphics. Like if I've seen a screenshot of it, I'd recognize it. But if somebody was playing it with like a skin on it or something, I wouldn't recognize what it was.
I see. So now I'm running out of wood as well, so basically I constantly need to press buy on grain and wood.
Buy!
Oh yeah, there's no mass buy. Oh, there we go. How many enemies is that? 6, I guess. And I'm number 3 in the ranking now, finally. After all this time. Because they started out with 40k gold. It was, and I started out with 3k gold.
Typical AI.
Yeah, but some of them are actually really good at economy now, so they're not even that bad. And they didn't even lose their gold all the way. Unlike some of them.
Uh-oh.
The really insane ones, they just spend everything on warriors right away and send it towards you.
Aha, I'm rich, so I can spend everything.
Yep, you just squander it all. Oh boy, I'm catapults. So rich. Let's see if I can use these catapults to kick their ass. Oh yes, nothing could go wrong here.
Nah, nothing, Florian, mate.
Florian has the best laugh out of anyone I know, just because he has the machine gun laugh. No, you do like what's that?
That's the one. Oh yeah,
it's so satisfying to hear it.
Is it?
Yeah.
I thought it was being weird.
Nah, it's fucking good. Better than my high-pitched laugh.
What about that laugh I do that sounds like Marge Simpson?
Did I miss something?
I don't
even
know if she laughs.
Really annoyingly. I can't do it now, though, that I'm trying to.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, she has a like... really, really annoying voice.
Yeah,
she does that. Yeah.
Yeah,
I do that too. And it's...
No, homie. I do that. I do that when I can't live. I literally can't breathe anymore. Like I'm laughing so hard that I'm just like.
Oh God, it sounds so dumb. Why do I do it like that?
Marge, who ate all the donuts?
Yep, that's what happens. Did I send out my catapults yet? Oh no, they're still in there, amongst the shields. If you could spot it right there, in the middle of the screen.
Well, you know, if Poor Mouse doesn't become a success, then you can always just double as a as a Marge impressionist.
Yeah.
Oh no.
I think he would be good for the new Wolfenstein games. Like just an evil scientist.
Yeah.
Oh man, yeah.
Go, he is in the building, do it now.
That's a me.
Not Mario.
That's a me. A Florian.
A Florian.
Yahoo!
Yep, just a Florian. Oh, there we go. Here comes the catapults. Maybe. If ever I wasn't constantly under siege, then maybe I could actually go on the offense for once.
Nope, God, look at it. Defensive.
Just constant attacks.
Damn, son.
However will I deal? And there I'm trying to build different gatehouses, but I hate actually using gatehouses because they would always just be shut. So I just make the walls really thin so they have to funnel through a bottleneck instead of a gatehouse.
Nice.
But it somehow is blocked, nice. So it takes me a while to figure that out, that I have to accidentally blocked it off, I guess. There, am I sending the catapults out finally? Hooray. Here they come. Cool. There, look at my little offensive party.
Damn.
Shooting the cows at them. The multiple cows that I somehow had, even though I only have 3 cows. Man, those cows are pretty big. Are cows really that big?
Yeah, they are.
Yeah, they're pretty big.
Oh wait, no they're not. They're big now, but back in the Middle Ages they weren't that big.
Oh, yeah.
This game is full
of... How do you know? You didn't live in the Middle Ages.
Oh yeah.
It's Florian, he is all knowing.
But he is middle aged.
Don't you believe in evolution? Shit. Oh you bastard, you. You're middle aged. I show you middle aged.
Just reminding you of your mortality, Florian, don't worry.
Hey, he still looks good for a middle aged man.
I'm not middle aged at 28,
you
dimwit.
Yeah.
Oh,
shit. Stop rock skim.
Look at that! Just massive armies approaching every second. There's no way to sneak out any offensive party.
Maybe you should wait until they stop.
They never stop. There's 6 of them. One of them will be attacking at any time.
Yep.
They just wait for the RNG just rolling that we're gonna attack.
Yeah, I suppose sometimes they all attack at once and then you could probably roll out. But then one of them will surely not have joined in, and then they'll attack as soon as you don't
You're
meet
open.
Them to. Yeah.
Yeah, I would,
Cow! Oh, missed the cow. Oh no.
You cow.
Yeah. Oh man. So yeah. The catapult strats don't look too promising at the moment. Look how boxed in I am there.
What's the most satisfying secret or Easter egg that you've found in the game that you can like remember?
Well, then I'm the only one who found it, or what?
At any point, what's the most satisfying Easter egg / secret that you've found in the game?
I'm not actually into those kinds of things at all, so.
Oh really?
Don't tell anyone.
I just think that it's good to put stuff like that in because every little sort of counts to.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, but I really don't pay attention to them myself when I am playing other games.
I have one that I can remember because I like Easter eggs, but usually I have to I have to search them up, you know, to know where they are. But I do know of one that I found by accident. It was Dying Light, and there was this chimney I was parkouring on.
I'm removing the catapults, by the way, because that plan didn't work.
Okay. And basically, I went down the chimney, and all of a sudden, me and Colin were in Super Mario Land, and you had like a rip-off song of Super Mario, and just like green pipes everywhere. Like, I thought that was an amazing Easter egg, like
Super Mario.
Just like a 3D first-person. Like a 3D first-person Mario. It was really fucking awesome.
You ever saw that video where someone made a first-person version of Mario?
Yeah,
I saw someone make it in Doom. Like, you see Super Mario Doom.
Mario is everywhere.
So you, because you don't like them, does that mean we're not going to see them in Kermos?
Well, depends. Probably not because there's no time, but... I probably would make them, it's just... I just don't like them in other games. Well, I suppose I don't... They'd probably just be inside jokes, not really Easter eggs. So now I'm going to try to use a siege tower, but there's still constant attacks going on, so it's really hard to sneak past the siege tower.
And to I saw Monkey Man
in Halo 3.
Everyone at once. Monkey Man, huh?
Yeah, in Halo 3.
Oh yeah,
everybody knows that one.
Nope.
Yeah, there's
except you flying like because you never had an Xbox.
Yeah. There's a monkey family just randomly sitting on the side of a big like
level one, I think. Bit.
Yeah.
God, video players a bit.
And they had a teddy bear.
Alright, I just want to skip forward to where I actually start attacking properly.
Okay.
It's taking forever. Wait, is it? Yeah. I still haven't killed anyone, and that's 1:40 in. 1 hour 40 minutes. Oh boy.
Jesus.
And I can't actually tell because the map's not even always there. Well, I guess. Oh no, the Caliph's still there. The Caliph's the only one that I can remotely attack, but he's pretty much the worst castle to attack because he's got fire everywhere. As I'm soon to find out again.
You should make some of those traps too.
It would be pointless. It's just too many.
Well, they managed to fuck you up.
Yeah, but they're not actually getting any soldiers past my towers.
Like, how much do they cost to make anyway?
They're fairly cheap. But they're only one time use, so I'd have to rebuild them every time. If I just sent a bunch of archers on my tower, they'll just shoot forever and it costs me nothing.
I guess it's good that if you don't have to even pay attention and you know how, that we're going to get destroyed by them.
Indeed. So I finally managed to put down a siege tower onto his castle now, and I'm sending in the macemen. I guess it's too bad I didn't show how I put that siege tower there, but we'll see it again probably.
Oh yeah, for anyone wondering out there, most of my Flash games have Easter eggs and secrets in them. Just saying. No,
they wrecked my siege tower as soon as I got there. Damn it.
By the time Poor Mouse is done, I'll probably be helping with the coding. I'll make some Dark Souls Easter eggs.
Yeah, you wish. I'm sick of making a whole section though, a whole new version of Poor Mouse that's basically Dark Souls themed.
Damn.
Afterwards. It's just some whole kind of dark fantasy setting.
Yeah, that could be quite cool actually. It could be cool if you had like a big massive castle, but obviously since you're a mouse you can go through like little holes in the wall and stuff.
Oh dude, you should have like a very big castle would it be then. Jesus Christ.
No, it'll be mouse sized. Alright, I rebuilt my siege towers. Am I using them now?
Or you go down onto the beach and there's a sand castle, you crawl into it and it's a massive castle inside.
Oh god.
That could be quite cool.
Guys ever played the game Medieval?
Yeah.
I think I've heard of it.
Medieval was awesome.
Yeah. I guess I played it like for a really short time because there was a demo somewhere.
Yeah, it has...
You always got the demo disc with some game.
It's a very old game and it's very, it's I don't know if it's aged well or not. I used to play it on the PlayStation Portable.
Well, it clearly hasn't.
Well, right. It's not because I remember they had massive fog in it. Fog.
Yeah. Here we go. Finally, there's an opening. Let me send out the siege towers. Here they come. Yeah, it's just like Lord of the Rings with the siege towers. Aim for the trolls, not the towers.
No, isn't it aim for the towers, not the trolls?
No. The trolls are pushing the towers, you see.
Oh, the trolls who are pushing the towers. Yeah.
Alright. Ooh, looks like I disarmed some of the traps as well. Great.
Yes.
Here I come.
Send enough people in that traps aren't possible.
Oh, they're possible. You just gotta send them in first. Oh, look, I'm safe scumming. Because I already did this part many times, and I'm just so pissed of how you just set everything on fire when you send your troops in.
Damn.
Yeah, here
just
I go.
He's exchanging shots like mad.
And then he set his entire castle on fire, and all my guys died, and they were right in front of him, too. It's pretty much as good as it can get. Ugh, awful.
That's not good if everyone died.
Well, yeah, because he set his own castle on fire.
Oh, he's using that Destiny Bond.
What's that?
It's another Pokemon move.
Oh, no.
The Pokemon sends out like a Destiny Bond at the target, and if in the same move, the target takes out the Pokemon who used Destiny Bond, also gets taken out with it.
Amazing. Well, here we go.
Yep. Pokemon fact of this video.
Thank you for saying this video, not this day.
And every time it gets set on fire. So what I gotta do is bait the fire and then move back and then move in once it's done. But meanwhile I'm getting shot at from all sides. It's awful. There, fire is set. And it's gone. Go! And here I go. Wreck him.
Here we go.
And how far am I in? 2 hours 11 minutes till I kill the first AI.
Wow. I would not have the patience for that.
Indeed.
Erin just came out the bath, and she had the Wii U gamepad in there. She put it down and she's playing Isaac on it.
Wow.
Who's that?
Erin, my girlfriend.
Erin? Right.
Yeah. You have a girlfriend?
Maybe.
What is it with you British people and calling women male names?
Erin.
I'm sorry I'm cheating on you, Florian. I'm sorry.
Wait, she's not a woman.
Dun dun dun, plot twist of the year.
Oh man, look at this. How my castle has grown now. Now I can buy 200 grain. Oh, that's gonna make a lot of bread.
Is it the plot twist when Trump became president instead of...
Nah, that was meant to be.
It was necessary.
It was necessary. Or else we would all be hailing Satan now. That wouldn't be good.
You hear of the recounts.
Oh, I heard about it, but it's never gonna pass.
Christ and more.
What's with that bullshit anyways? They're recounting only the countries where Trump won? How stupid is that? Yep. How unfair. Why is that allowed? Wouldn't they have to recount everything?
Well, let's just say the politics are a bit corrupt.
I think bullshit that's even allowed.
They could cry some more.
They really could.
Tough shit, it's over.
Alright, so let's see what's the target of my next attack, I wonder.
Yeah, I think you're gonna attack the blue ones.
Nope, looks like I'm going down there.
You lose.
I don't even know what color he is, he's off map, kind of. Oh, I guess he might be black. No, he's orange.
You can't just say that they're black.
They've got a black flag! Like pirates! Oh look, I'm building trebuchets, hooray!
Do they have, like, skulls on them though?
Nope, it's medieval.
Then we're not pirates then.
Yep. Send in the troops! Fire the trebuchets! It's time! To arms!
It's time for what?
For war! Look, that's how you use horse archers. You run around with them so that they get shot less.
Good idea.
Ah, meanwhile, the black guy has attacked me with his melee units and wrecked my trebuchets. Well, I really cleared off his towers, but will I be able to get in? Who knows? These are really annoying castles to get by as well, because there's There's deadly traps around the water, but your units are too retarded to dig in one spot, so if you tell them to dig, they'll just spread out all over the water, and therefore they'll get killed by all the traps.
You wish you had castles like that.
Yeah, look at those castles with the moat everywhere. I can't,
you should
though.
Practice making those.
I don't want to make them like that. It wastes space. Look at my efficient town.
But the impenetrable defenses are...
Look, they penetrated my defenses and now they're just getting shot in the back. They've got nothing.
I'm sure you, as the player, can take more of an advantage of it.
Huh?
Like, if they make it, like, super elaborate, but then you can still go for it. Surely you can. It can be the opposite, except the fact that you can keep the entrance well guarded.
You lost
so
me.
So they can't get through.
Well, so you think I should build more elaborate castles? I think simple is the best way to go.
Yeah, simple, so you can get lost and there's no plot holes. Like, there's no secret, I forgot this part.
God.
It depends.
Look at that, he had assassins there, but they got wrecked, luckily. Assassins are really strong, too. They're almost as strong as monks.
I mean, we do have assassin in the name.
Well, yeah. But
you'd expect an assassin to be professional, right?
Well, you'd not expect an assassin to 1v1 a mace man with a shield.
Ass!
In this game, can you edit the terrain?
Yes, there is a map editor, but you can't do it while you play.
Oh, so you can't make moats like he did.
Oh, you can make moats. You just make... It's one of the buildings, but you have to actually send your soldiers to dig them. But you can make moats as... given that you're on ground level, I guess.
I like how Total Annihilation as a map maker too.
I bet. Yeah, now I got two enemies dead. But will my armies be able to retreat or will they get wrecked down there?
They get wrecked.
Tune in next time.
Nope.
Yes, this is Pokemon Paul.
How long's the video? Oh, Jesus. Sorry.
The Dragon Ball E.
Taking too much time. All right, let's just see what happens next. I'm sure my army died. Oh, is that still the same army? Oh yeah, I tried build. Oh god, look at my mistakes there. I'm sending in engineers, but they're just getting shot before they can even reach their buildings.
Got them.
Terrible. Yeah, and then this is one engineer who builds the trebuchet, but he's not. He needs two more engineers to man it. And meanwhile, I'm getting shot by millions of arrows. And that was a failed attempt. Alright, let's see what I do next. Looks like I got wiped, so I had to start from scratch.
I know.
By the way, at first I had only 300 possible army. Because there were so many players on the map, so many lords, I guess. Lords is what they're called. But the more you kill them, the bigger the army limit gets. The more of them die.
But also thank you, my lord.
The enemies can make more armies too, unfortunately. Alright, here we go. Got another siege tower and another troops, but they... Of course they walk right into another invasion by three of the characters. Typical. Oh god, now I'm supposed to attack the wolf. Well, the wolf has really insane castles. He's got four mangonels next to each other.
Mangonels.
I'm not sure if I'm saying that right. It's the catapults that shoot a bucket full of smaller rocks, and they're really effective against troops.
Airstrike!
Yeah. It's like bullets!
Oh man, it should have been like used nappies.
Oh no.
God!
That'll get him good.
Not like this.
And it slows down the other characters.
Oh yeah. It's just like when you're firing the cows. Yeah, there's the mangonels, by the way. Right on this side. Where the castle is. My arm is looking good. I wonder how it'll go. Skipping forward.
Let's find out.
Oh great, of course he's sending in another big troop of pikemen.
Of course he is.
Typical.
Typical, typical, typical.
I actually don't usually use pikemen, but in this game I do because they're kind of good for moats.
Disposable, I guess.
They're really tanky, but they have no attack power. But they're good for digging moats because you don't need attack power to dig moats.
You just need a shovel or spade.
Yeah, which they conveniently keep up their ass.
Ah yes, gotta keep a shovel up their ass.
Everyone's got magical shovel powers. Wherever they get them, who knows. Well, I suppose they might be able to dig with sticks, but who knows.
Wear hands, maybe?
Maybe indeed. I guess it's just symbolized by shovels in the game. And all the while I have to buy grain to sell bread. It's awful. Just because they couldn't give me some oasis to build on, so I wouldn't have to constantly micromanage my bread.
Oh dear.
Indeed. Alright, here goes the attack. And here fires the mangonels. Look at that. Fucking machine gun going on up here. Yeah, they're pretty much wrecking me right there.
Get wrecked!
Raw. Yep, half my arm is gone. And I still need to get down that first wall so I can dig the moat and then send in the siege tower. And then, of course, I have no units left.
Damn it.
Yep, that was a failure.
No more people left to kill others with.
No.
Damn it. Who else am I going to send to kill other people for me?
Well, at least he set his own shit on fire. That's something. Great. Alright, let's see the next attack, whenever that happens. Will I ever learn? Oh look, I'm making lots of shields, that's cool.
Shields are good.
They're really effective.
Super effective, in fact.
Against arrows, at least. I built another tower, great. Oh, here we go.
Can you build like boats in this to kick across the water?
Nope, that's why I'm completely fucked here, because I can't actually cross there.
Yeah.
So I need to go right through where he's best defended, I guess.
In total annihilation, you can make ships.
I bet. In Cossacks as well, but I don't usually play on maps that have water in Cossacks. Oh god, look at them. No, don't attack my soldiers, how could you? No! My shields!
I like using the planes in Total Annihilation because they don't take up the space on the ground. And that they can just fly freely and quickly.
Convenient.
There's so much arrows just flying everywhere.
I know, but man, did you see that huge army he sent at me then? That was inconvenient as fuck. Especially because I was just attacking.
Well, you're fine still, are you at least?
Oh yeah, they're never gonna kill me now that I've got these towers filled with crossbow, man. It's just so hard to actually attack them in this mission, at least. Normally it's not that tough, but they're just really close together, these castles. So you always get shot from several castles.
I bet it's like having many sentries up there. Level 1 sentries.
No.
Or mini sentries.
It's packed. No, he's sending in horse archers to die. Yes, animal cruelty. Alright, am I sending that troop in yet? Okay, looks like I'm sending it down there. That's good. Oh, looks like I went around the terrible wolf's castle. I'm attacking the slightly less powerful castle by the Emir. But I don't actually have a lot of great army there. Oh wait, no, I do. It's just behind that tower. Great.
Ooh.
Yeah, looks like okay. I've tuned in just in time for me to kill that other AI. There, I've wrecked his tower.
Ooh.
Now wreck your shit.
Ah, shit, I only have 20 units left. That won't do. Oh wait, no, there's some more pikemen.
How can you wreck shit if you don't have the tools to do it?
There, look at that. Woo! Here they come. Just enough to kill him. I only brought about 10 units too many, otherwise I wouldn't have killed him.
If yep. I
brought 11 less.
Good thing you've got a ton of units.
Yeah, now. And I can make 400 something army. Oh shit, and look at this guy now. He is pissed. Because I forgot to buy food. You like him? You said he almost smiled, but he's not smiling now.
Morale is too low.
Yeah, he's pissed that I didn't buy food.
How dare you, you self-centered prick.
You starved us with your warmonger ring. You'll pay for that. I'm out of here.
Keeping all the bread to yourself.
Yeah. Or just completely absent-minded, forgot to buy the bread.
It would be cool if you could customize your flag in these games.
I think you can. Well, I guess there's a preset number.
It might be quite bad for online, because obviously people can put bad stuff on, but still.
Yeah, like dicks. When Mario Kart DS came out, and people can make their own emblems, they could just use vulgar ones online.
Oh, photorealistic dick here.
Like, you just put a dick in your emblem.
Just a real life dick pic.
Swastika.
Oh, yes. Now we're talking. Alright, looks like I'm sending in a new army of 200 crossbowmen. That's gonna take
behind
care
shields.
Of them.
Yep. Well, must look rather camouflaged.
Yeah, in that desert, it's almost the same color.
Oh yeah, that tower does not look suspicious at all either.
Yeah. Well, everything is well spotted in this game. Alright, let's see where I attack. I have to slowly walk around the terrible castle of the wolf. Otherwise, I'll get wrecked by the mangonels again. Oh my god, look, another huge army.
Mangonels.
Wait, you've got your own huge army, bro.
Indeed, and mine is ranged, so they've got no chance, but I still gotta wait for them to die before I can advance.
But this army looks like a Call of Players large army.
Yeah, there's yellow and black in there.
Yeah, there's white guys too.
Yellow is the wolf and black is the... Well, if you look, they're black, the white ones. There's no white.
Oh.
They're
black
Templar
and white,
knights.
I guess.
The Templar Knights and the color of the cross, that's the color they have.
Those three guys are skulls now.
Oh yeah.
Half of them are skulls, the rest need to be killed off.
Indeed.
Look at your guys, this is my guys. They have no chance.
Yeah. I really got lots of army going on there.
Oh yeah.
You're just look- throwing stuff at him and looking at him, he's like, fuck!
Look at that
how
guy
could you have outsmarted us?
On the bottom where the map was.
Yep. Yeah.
Which one was he?
Next
he
to the
like,
monk.
Fuck.
Right, but
how
which
could
one?
You have outsmarted
Lionheart, I think.
Oh yeah, he's.
It was a guy with armor.
Oh. Yeah, I guess that's him. Or it was the wolf, actually.
Oh no, getting confused.
Who knows? There, look at my army go. This should be enough to kill the Lionheart.
Could be.
Most tents are black and white, surely, but not your side.
Nope, mine's all red. I like being red. It's my favorite color in games.
Same here.
Red. Red is considered to intimidate people.
Indeed.
I like green a lot.
I hate when I have to be blue by default. I mean, blue is the second best, but why not just be red? That's the best.
Nah, purple is the second best.
Damn, you've seen that Game Theory video? Why red is better than blue?
Oh yeah,
sure have. It's the best. Oh,
yeah, but green sort of a neutral color, so
yeah.
Sure is, it blends in. Anyways, looks like I still had the veterans from that last battle down there, so now I'm really building up a huge army there.
Oh man, just, wouldn't Team Fortress 2 be cool if it had 4 teams in one map instead of 2?
Oh yeah, that'd be great.
Just imagine like a yellow team and a green team and you'll be like 6v6v6v6.
Oh yeah, alright, here goes that'd my be attack. So cool. Look at his tiny little castle. It's so random how big and small they get at times.
Yeah. That's what she said.
Yes.
Fucking big.
In her cock teachings. her cock studies.
Cock studies. Man, she just stopped there.
Yes.
In her cock.
Alright, here we go. Siege tower ready, and here comes my units. Swarming
yeah, how
into his castle.
How the hell are we gonna get shields in there? Do we just fold it up like flat pack?
Who knows? It's actually quite
expand it.
Actually quite random. I guess it must fold up, yeah. It's the only siege equipment they can place on towers. Except for the ones that you can only build up there and not move them.
Look at us green people. Oh, what green people?
There is no green people.
They're we look yellow. Green. Oh man, it must be the colour, I guess. It looked like green to me.
Huh.
Yeah, look how plenty of gold you got now.
Yeah. And my popularity was falling again. Oh look, I'm also attacking right away with that army. It's gonna be easier to attack the wolf from this side.
How are you gonna get in?
Well, just through there. I'll just bring another siege tower. Well, these
we'll
guys
never
are
know.
Dead. So I'm gonna just skip forward to my next attack.
That means surely that you'll have one person to kill after that.
One or two, I'm not sure. There's a lot of people in this.
Because, yeah. Like, there were three guys left. You just killed one, and you're starting to kill another one.
I'm not
sure. So you're
gonna
have one afterwards.
I guess so, yeah. Sometimes I play
some
games, and then I'm surprised that there's another guy there right next to the one guy that I fought.
Fair enough.
Wait, where did he come from?
Yeah, he was hiding.
You think you would have noticed his fancy as fuck castle then?
Yeah. Thought it was right next to the other castle. Sometimes they're really close together and then they build joint castles, but not very intelligently.
Your enemy is in another
castle. Oh no! There's my siege tower, look at it.
Look it roll.
I wonder if this is playing poorly, because it's such a big file. I guess that must be what's happening here. Sorry about that.
You got quite a big base, though.
I sure do.
You earn that corner.
Yeah. It's full of impressive construction building. Industrious buildings. That's why I can afford such huge armies, because there's so much weapon industry going on.
I love how they were just running over the rocks there.
Yeah.
So revolutionary.
Well, they're running behind the rocks, but yeah. Alright, here goes the army.
Yay.
Who to get fucked next?
The wolf.
Oh no, not bestiality.
Oh no, wolf job.
Not wolf job.
That army's not big enough. I think I'm gonna get more. Nope, never mind. Here I go.
Straight into the action. Look at their walls. Just go down like a loading bar.
Yeah, too bad. It's another wall behind it. And then a moat. A tiny one tile moat, annoyingly.
Your death is loading. Please stand by.
It's not loading fast enough. But luckily the crossbows are really doing their job. They're really taking out those ranged units he has.
Does anyone actually remember Wolf Job?
Nope.
No. Oh god.
I just remember from Game Grumps mentioning it over and over. Alright, now I can finally take my revenge on those fucking mangonels. Take him, Mace Man, take him.
Take it up your ass.
Yeah, look at that. Oh wow, he's killed my tower, my siege tower with his pikemen.
And that guy at the bottom's like, yeah, you go get him.
Yeah. He's not pleased with my attack.
No, I mean the guy holding the book.
Oh. Right. Because the wolf was also talking.
Well, he's going like, yeah, you go.
The wolf is, I may have underestimated you.
God damn it, why couldn't I see you coming?
Do I have enough army up there to attack him with? Come on, get him. Oh, I do actually, cool. And now that... Oh wow, they were there all along.
You leveled the entire area.
Yeah, I killed all the people there. With my crossbow man.
You did it, you got 500 gold.
That was the hardest one, now the next one's just easy.
The guy would rather die than be on your side.
Yeah. He's not to be trifled with. Alright, more engineers. Why am I making engineers? Oh, I'm making catapults, yeah. Go on, catapults. Skipping forward again.
Stab him in the head. And then chop off his balls.
Oh no. You monster. There we go. Oh, I see.
More fire traps.
That fire trap was actually from the Vasir, not from the wolf. Right. I thought that was weird. Yeah, gotta love those catapults. Oh no, that's just how he builds. Because you can't make diagonal walls. Yeah. You mean here, where I wrecked it? That's just how I wrecked it.
A little higher.
Oh, that, yeah, that's just... He just built it like that. If only you could look at the flatness of it, then you'd see how it's built.
Damn isometric.
Yeah. Well, I just have to press space, but I can't now because it's pre-recorded.
Of course. Yeah. Instead, you'll just pause the video.
Indeed. Now look at how beautiful. Isn't it so satisfying how the catapults tear through his castle?
Yes.
Needs to be faster.
It's like art.
Oh, yes. And then the catapults shoot my own men. Oh, no.
Charge!
Yes, now get in there, you heavily armored bastards.
Super fast attacking.
Whee! And in they run. Ta-da!
Victory!
I did it!
Well, by the wins!
By the way, in case you're wondering what amazing cinematic comes next, it's just the same garbage from last time.
Oh yeah, that silly justice shit.
They didn't even make a different one with the new characters, nope. It's just the same old characters. The basic
all
8.
That progress.
Yeah, look how much money I made. Not even as much as the wolf. How did he manage? Oh shit, that's my desktop. Alright, subscribe for more Stronghold. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Bye. Bye.